Shri Vijay Sai Reddy, not present. Shri K.C. Ramamurthy,
sir,
lekar dijiye.
Sir, can I?
Yes, subject, please.
Yes, sir. Sir, through this special mention, I would like to bring to the attention of the government the urgent need to conduct common law admission test by a statutory body. Sir, every common entrance examination is expected to be conducted with utmost care and caution, since career of lot of students would be at stake. Entrance exams such as NEET, CAT, etc. are being conducted by professional bodies,
okay,
which give little scope for any malpractice or mistakes. But when it comes to CLAT, it is the other way around. CLAT,
please,
is an examination,
please,
for admission to 18 law universities in the country, and this is conducted by one of the 18 law, national law school, law universities every year on rotation basis since 2008. There is no doubt that national law universities have professionalism in teaching law, but lacks professionalism in conducting CLAT, which has resulted in leakage of question paper in 2008, 2009, question booklet in 2011 contained questions with answers underlined, deviated from syllabus in 2012, erroneous ranks were announced, questions plagiarized in 2015 from CLAT and website with erroneous questions. Some questions have more than one correct answers in 2017. So this clearly indicates that since common test began in 2008, almost every year CLAT is mirrored with controversies and riddled with errors, with more than 50,000 students appearing for 2,175 seats in reputed 18 national law universities. It indicates the intensity of competition as this exam produces peerless advocates for the country. In view of the above, it is important to conduct CLAT by a professional body, either by the Bar Council of India itself or some other professional body which can be constituted for this purpose by the government. Hence, I request the Government of India to take CLAT exam seriously and make it error-free. Thank you, sir.
I associate with
KC now. Sri Truchi Shiva.
Thank you, Mr. Vice Chairman. Sir, urging the government to reconsider its policy to involve private sector in defence sector. Sir, defence is the most important sector which is owned by the government currently. It is important for the government to ensure secrecy and efficiency within the sector. Ministry of Defence, in its circular dated April 21, 2017, declared certain items as non-core. It further stated that such items can be procured from sources other than ordnance factories without obtaining a no-objection certificate, which opens up the purchase avenues from private sector. Government had said that the purpose of strategic partnership model is to increase the efficiency in the defence sector. Ordnance factories had achieved 96%, 94% and 96% in the years 2012-13, 2013-14 and 2014-15 respectively. Hence, the efficiency of these factories is not low. The government has also approved disinvestment in Bharat Earth Movers Limited, which produces equipments for the defence sector in India. New rules regarding small arms were made in 2016, which increased the role private sector in small arms sector. The government is also planning to privatise ordnance factories. A new private small arms manufacturing unit has been opened in partnership with an Israel company. This leads to dilution of defence sector ownership from government to private bodies. There are 41 ordnance factories which employ 12,51,000 people. Through such government action, these people will lose their livelihood. Such action by the ministry will adversely affect the security of this country. I urge the government to reconsider its policy towards the revitalization of defence sector through involving private sector companies in it.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Okay. Shri Ali Anwar Ansari?
Not present.
Not present. Shri Derek Oberon?
Sir, I'm not reading, I'm only laying.
Okay.
Sir, the subject of my special mention today is on the data security and privacy of Aadhaar cards. I have a notice next week, so I don't want to read it. The issue is in two sentences, sir. I don't want to read the whole thing. There are more than 100 crore Indians who've given out their personal data for education, for health, for payment. That data is very precious. And last week only 13 crore people had their private data leaked. That's all, sir.
Yes. Only he is speaking about the subject.
On the yes. Sir, this is only on the subject.
Okay, okay.
The data is very precious. I'm sending in one sentence.
You cannot read even one word apart from that.
Sir, I'm reading it to you, sir. There have been data lapses.
Subject matter only, please.
I'm reading it from here. Okay. 115 crore Indians, sixth line from the bottom.
Okay.
115 crore, about 100 crore Indians have their Aadhaar numbers. Their payment, health and education records are being stored digitally. This personal data has to be kept personal, not made public. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Shri D. Bandyopadhyay, not present. Shri Manish Gupta, not present. Shri Kaikasha Parveen. श्रीमती केकेशा परवीन
बहुत-बहुत शुक्रिया उपसभापति महोदय मैं देश के करोड़ों लोगों को अपनी मातृभाषा में राष्ट्रीय व अंतर्राष्ट्रीय समाचारों को सुन पाने के अधिकार वाले सार्वजनिक महत्व के विषय को उठाना चाहती हूं जो कि अलग-अलग भाषाओं में सुनने बोलने व समझने वाले गरीब व दबे कुचले लोगों की सक्षमता के लिए बहुत जरूरी है आकाशवाणी में संविधान की 8वीं अनुसूची में शामिल भाषाओं के क्षेत्रीय समाचारों के अलावा राष्ट्र बुलेटिन भी चलाए जाते हैं जिसमें राष्ट्रीय व अंतर्राष्ट्रीय समाचार शामिल होते हैं विभिन्न युद्धों व हमलों के समय आकाशवाणी के समाचार मुख्यालय के समाचार सेवा प्रभाग दिल्ली से शुरू किए गए राष्ट्रीय समाचार बुलेटिन देश के संघीय भावनाओं के अनुसार लगभग 60-65 वर्षों से दिल्ली से ही प्रसारित किए जा रहे थे देश के पहले सूचना प्रसारण मंत्री सरदार पटेल जी ने अपने कार्यकाल में 6 भाषाओं के राष्ट्रीय समाचार बुलेटिन को दिल्ली से शुरू कर इस व्यवस्था को मजबूती दी थी प्रसार भारती चूंकि अब पीटीआई और यूनाई द्वारा दी जाने वाली समाचार सेवा को समाप्त करके ये काम एक खास एजेंसी को सौंप रही है उसकी भारतीय भाषाओं की समाचार सेवा को जीवित रखने के लिए प्रसार भारती ने दिल्ली में आकाशवाणी के भाषाई समाचार यूनिटों को बंद करके इसे राष्ट्र समाचार बुलेटिन संबंधित राज्य व क्षेत्रीय समाचार यूनिटों को भेज दिए हैं प्रसार भारती की ऑटोनॉमी व समाचार के संपादकीय रंग पकड़ लेने के खतरे जैसे व्यापक विषय को छोड़ भी दिया जाए तो भी राष्ट्र बुलेटिनों के को राज्य में भेज दिए जाने से देश की राजधानी में इन भाषाओं की उपस्थिति पर असर पड़ेगा और राज्य में समाचारों की गुणवत्ता और बुलेटिनों का राष्ट्र स्वरूप कमज़ोर हो जाएगा इस कार्रवाई के चलते आकाशवाणी में सैकड़ों लोगों का रोजगार खत्म हो रहा है इसलिए मैं सरकार से गुजारिश करती हूँ कि दिल्ली में आकाशवाणी के भाषाई यूनिटों के राष्ट्रीय समाचार बुलेटिनों को फिर से शुरू किया जाए
धन्यवाद शुक्रिया श्री दिलीप कुमार त्रिकी यस ओके थैंक यू श्री वंसुक सयाम नॉट प्रेजेंट श्री रथिन वेल नॉट प्रेजेंट चौधरी मनोवर सलीम हाँ धन्यवाद Ratnivel.
Yes. The ordnance factory at Tiruchirappalli is one of the 41 Indian ordnance factories functioning. Under the ordnance factories board established
You may speak about subject only. You may lay.
Yes, read.
Yes.
I will read.
If you are you laying?
Yes.
Okay.
To increase the small arms production in the country, OFP has been well equipped with all latest and modern machine tools and upgraded its state-of-the-art technology which was conceptualized for having strong patriotic relation with the armed forces and not for having profit-making commercial relation. It's sad to note that the government has a proposal to privatize 4 small arms factories under the ordnance factory board including OFT under the public private participation system and categorized around 143 items produced by ordnance factories as non-core items and that the army is allowed to procure these items from indigenous sources. The employees of OFD has played a vital role to achieve self-reliance in defense equipments required for armed forces and have stood all along with the government when the developed countries refused to transfer the warfare technology to our country. It is our bitter experience that this forced many foreign imports in defense were involved with huge corruption, and if private manufacturers along with FDI are allowed in the defense production, then the question of integrity will arise since with the foreign arms dealers. There can be concerns about passing of the equipment's designs or source code to enemy countries. Therefore, I urge the Union Government to refrain from privatization of organization factory Tiruchirappalli and to protect the interests of national security.
Thank you. Sadan ki karvai dinank 26 July 2017 budhwar pratah 11 baje tak ke liye sthagit ki jayegi.